Hi there, student. Welcome to my channel. So in this slot, we're going to discuss Chapter 3, Chemicals, Formula and Equation. Okay, let me start with the first one. As we know, matter consists of what? Consists of matter, anything that has mass and occupies space. This matter consists of particles that made up of A, M, I. The A stands for atom, M molecule and ion. The mass of an atom is tiny and light, and it's very difficult to measure the mass of an atom directly. Therefore, scientists use a method of comparison. They compare the mass of an atom by using a standard atom, and we assign standard atom hydrogen, oxygen, and till now we use carbon prop. Alright, let me start with hydrogen atom. The hydrogen atom used as a comparison because this hydrogen atom is a lightest atom with the mass they assign as 1.00. One oxygen atom has equal mass as 16 hydrogen atom. Therefore, the RAM of oxygen atom is 16.00. One helium atom has equal mass as 4 hydrogen atom. Therefore, the RAM of helium atom is 4.00. Later on, the hydrogen is found not suitable as a comparison because the mass of hydrogen atom is difficult to measure as it exists as gas, and also the hydrogen atom has a few isotopes with different mass. Then scientists assign oxygen as a standard atom. This is because oxygen can react with almost all other elements. The mass or the relative atomic mass of oxygen, which has been used as a standard atom, has been assigned as 16.00. Later on, the oxygen is found not suitable as a comparison because these are three isotopes with different mass. And finally, the scientists use carbon 12 as a standard atom. The carbon 12 atom used as standard atom till now, and this carbon 12 atom is 12 times heavier than hydrogen atom. Thus, all the hydrogen atom has been compared with 1 over 12 of mass of carbon atom. So we try to check what is this mean. Alright, so here I check. Okay, one carbon 12 atom is cut into 12 pieces. Okay, it's divided into 12 pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And when we remove one fraction, this will be equivalent to 1 over 12. If let's say we want to determine the RAM of helium, the relative atomic mass of helium, we try to put the cut the carbon atom into, then we try to put the helium atom into the balancer. It is found 4 times 1 over 12 of carbon 12 atom needed to balance the helium atom. Therefore, we can conclude the RAM, relative atomic mass. The relative atomic mass of helium is 4 times 1 over 12 of carbon 12 atom. Therefore, the RAM of helium is 4. We take the 4. Alright, so we try to check the RAM of few atoms. Oxygen atom has equal mass as 16 times 1 over 12 of carbon 12 atom. Therefore, the RAM of oxygen is 16.00. One sodium atom has equal mass as 23 times 1 over 12 carbon 12 atom. Therefore, the RAM of sodium is 23.00. Alright, the sulfur atom has an equal mass as 32 times 1 over 12 times mass of carbon atom. Therefore, the sulfur atom has RAM of 32.00. That means we try to do the equation to determine the relative atomic mass. We take the A, we put here average. We take the M, we put here average mass of one atom of N element. And these word symbols stand for when we compare. Okay, when compare with 1 over 12 times mass of one carbon 12 atom, where the RAM of carbon 12 is assigned as 12.00. Alright, we try to check for the particles. If let's say the particles present in atom, we will use average atomic mass. If the particles present in molecule, we will use relative molecular mass. If let's say the particles present in the form of ionic compound which exists in ion, we will use relative formula mass. We try to do for relative atomic mass. The relative atomic mass, we try to do the definition. So average mass of one atom of an element, when we compare with 1 over 12 times mass of one carbon 12 atom. The formula is already given here. The formula is already given. Your average mass of one atom of an element when compared with 1 over 12 times mass of carbon 12 atom. Alright, we try to do the formula for relative molecular mass. The relative molecular mass we try to do, okay, average mass of one molecule when compared with 1 over 12 times mass of one carbon 12. I'll do your carbon 12 atom. Alright, so we try to raise this. Okay, we try to do for the ionic compound, which is relative formula mass, the RFM. So we do average mass of one ionic compound when compared with 1 over 12 times mass of one carbon 12 atom. Alright, we try to check few calculate our relative atomic formula of few substance that given here. We check carbon is 12, then hydrogen is 1. We try to find the relative atomic mass of water 2 hydrogen times RAM of hydrogen is 1 plus 16 1, so 16 total will be 18. Alright, we try to do for the methane carbon is 12 plus hydrogen is 4 times RAM of hydrogen is 1, so that will be 16. We try to do for glucose, so the RAM of oxide atom is given here, 16. Alright, so we do carbon 6 times 12 RAM, oxygen 12 times 1 RAM, the 6 times 16 oxide RAM, that will be 180. Carbon dioxide got 4, 12 plus 2 times 16 RAM of oxygen, that will be 4. Alright, ethanoic acid, we have 1 carbon 12, we have 3 hydrogen 3 times 1 plus another carbon 12 plus we have 2 oxygen 2 times 16 plus we have last hydrogen, which will be 60. Alright, we try to do for the sodium chloride, the RAM of sodium is given here, sodium 23, and chloride is 35.5, therefore sodium 23 plus 35.5, which will be 58.5. okay, we try to do for this one, do as an exercise, we do try to do zinc nitrate. So the RAM of zinc is given 65, nitrogen is 14, oxygen is 16, and we try to calculate. So 65 zinc plus, when we see O bracket, so open bracket, close the bracket, so we try to put nitrogen 14 plus 3 times 16 oxygen and bring the two put in front, so the answer will be 189. All right and now we try to do for the this one do as an exercise. We try to do the for calcium. RAM of calcium is given 40, carbon is 12, oxygen is 16. We try to calculate. So 40 plus 12 plus 3 times 16, that will be 100. All right we try to do for the hydrated copper to sulfate, the RAM. Okay, the RAM of copper is 64, sulfur is 32, oxygen is 16, hydrogen is 1. We try to calculate together. So copper 64, then we have sulfur 32 plus 4 times 16. Alright, we have 4 times 16 plus we open bracket, close the bracket, put the 5 value in front, inside your car, hydrogen 2 times 1 plus 16, what down is 16 for water molecule. We try to find the answer will be 250. Alright, so please do this as a exercise. All right we go for the average mass of RAM and how to find the how many times of an atom is heavier than the relative atomic mass or standard atom, which is carbon. If the relative atomic mass of magnesium is 24 and the relative atomic mass of carbon is 12, so your RAM of magnesium is 24 and the RAM of carbon is 12, they want the how many times one magnesium atom is heavier than one carbon atom. Therefore the RAM of magnesium, when we divide with RAM of carbon, so 24 divided with 12, we will get 2 times heavier. Alright we try to do the second question. In an investigation, the element U is 12 times heavier than the neon neon atom, and the RAM of neon atom is given for. We need to calculate what is the relative atomic mass of U. So we do what? RAM of U divide with RAM of neon, it is 12 times heavier. So we try to find RAM of U 12 times RAM of neon. The RAM of neon is given 4, so times 4, so the answer will be 48. Alright, we try to do how many times 2 bromine atom is heavier than 5 oxygen atom. How many times 2 bromine atom is heavier than 5 oxygen atom. So RAM of bromine times 2 bromine atom divide with 5 oxide atom, RAM of oxide. So 2 times 80 divide with 5 times 16, that will be 2 times heavier. Alright, we try to do question number 4. Okay, how many times 4 calcium atom heavier than 2 neon atom? 4 times RAM of calcium divide with 2 times RAM of neon. So that will be 4 times 40 divide with 2 times 20. So which the answer will be 4 times heavier. Alright, we try to do how many, question number 5. How many carbon atoms? They want how many carbon atoms? Then they give clue here equal mass as 2. 2 krypton atoms. So we try to do how many carbon atom, I don't know, so I make it x. Alright, x times with RAM of carbon equal as 2 times RAM of krypton. Alright, so we try to find the x number of carbon atom. So how to find 2 times RAM of krypton divide with RAM of carbon. So 2 times krypton is 84 divide 12, that will be 14 carbon atoms. Alright, so please try to do this as a exercise. Alright, we go for next part. The concept of mole. Okay, mole is the unit. Mole is the unit used to measure the quantity. Quantity of atoms. Atoms, molecules, or ions that present in a substance. Alright, so the unit for mole will be mol. Alright, so always remember one mole of substance contains as many particles as the number of atoms in exactly 12.00 of carbon 12 atom. And always remember, if in the exam they ask what is mean by one mole, the key point is quantity of substance that contains as many particles as in exactly 12.00 gram of carbon 12 atom. And always remember Avogadro constant. What is mean by Avogadro constant? The number of particles that present in one mole of a substance. The number of particles that present in one mole of substance, and one mole of substance contains the same particles as in carbon 12 atom, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23, or this is known as Avogadro constant. Alright. Okay, and we try to check the quantity of unit or quantity of substance. Okay, this is the quantity, common quantity and unit. If a pair, we say 2 unit, we must remember 2 unit. If a dozen, we must remember 12 unit. A ream is 500 unit. One case is 24 unit. And when we go for one mole in chemistry, the student must remember Avogadro constant, or 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Alright, so we try to do few questions. Okay, one mole. Here they put one mole. Here they put one mole. If one mole, this is equivalent to Avogadro constant, and we see here Fe, one capital one small. Okay, helium, neon, all one capital, all this is belongs to atom. One mole of iron contains Avogadro constant 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. The student must state the type of particles, atoms. All right one mole of oxygen, O2, when non-metal plus non-metal, the type of particles will be molecule. Please remember few important non-metal, which is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, chloride, bromide, oxide, okay, and hydrogen. All these is non-metals, all right? When they combine together, they will form a molecule. So here, oxide, non-metal, the type of particles will be molecules. So I put here molecules. And when 1 mole, always remember 1 mole of any substance contains the type of particles that present in exactly 12 gram of carbon 12, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. All right, we go for 1 mole of sodium chloride. Okay, the 1 mole of sodium chloride contains how many particles? 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. And here sodium chloride, they exist when metal plus non-metal, they exist as ions. So my answer will be ions. Alright. Okay, we try to answer a few questions. Okay, we go for concept of mole and the number of moles. Number of moles and the substance. The number of moles, the unit will be N. Alright, small n will be number of mole. The molar mass means the mass of per mole of substance. The molar mass is refers to the RAM, RMM, and the unit of molar mass will be gram per mole. We try to do a few questions. Copper, the formula of copper Cu, the RAM of copper is 64 given here. Alright, 64, when we convert this into molar mass, 64.0 gram per mole. Alright, so we try to check for glucose, C6H12O6. We try to find the RMM of glucose, 6 times 12 plus 12 times 1 plus 6 times 16, which is 180. When we convert this into molar mass, that will be 180.0 gram per mole. Alright, so we go for ammonia. Ammonia gas is NH3. Nitrogen 14 plus 3 times 1 hydrogen, which will be 17. When we convert into molar mass, 17.0 gram per mole. Alright, so and the number of mole. Number of moles, the formula is N equals to mass over molar mass. Alright, so the number of mole I'll try to do here, N mass over molar mass. From this formula, if let's say mass is given, the unit is gram, the student must use this formula to calculate the number of mole. From this formula, we can rearrange the formula to calculate the mass. If we want to find the mass, number of mole times with molar mass. So we have two formula from this formula. Okay, we try to do the first question. The first question, determine the number of mole of 6 gram of carbon atom. 6 gram of carbon atom, and this is given mass. So we want to find what? We want to find what is the requirement of the question. They want us to find the number of mole, which is N. Alright, which is N. So formula N equals to mass over molar mass. So the mass is given 6 gram and the molar mass of our carbon is given 12. So the answer will be 0.5 mole. The unit for mole will be number of mole will be mol. Okay, we go for question number B. Determine the number of mole of 10 gram of copper, and the given number given here is carbon, copper. Copper symbol Cu, and the RAM of copper is given 64. So the formula, this is mass. So we want to find the number of mole, mass over molar mass. The mass is given 10 gram. The molar mass is 64. The molar mass of carbon dioxide in copper is 64. So we try to find the answer 0.16. The unit will be mole. We try to find the next question. Determine the number of mole of 8 gram. So this is 8 gram of helium. RAM of helium is given. So we try to find the number of mole, mass over molar mass. The mass is given 8. The molar mass is 4. So the answer will be 2.0 mole. Alright, we try to do question number D. Calculate or what is the mass? They want us to find the mass and given here 0.5. And we already got number of moles. So from this formula, mass over molar mass, we need to find mass. So rearrange the formula. Mass is number of mole times with molar mass. The number of mole already given here 0.5. The molar mass of glucose. So glucose, the formula C6H12O6. So open bracket, 6 times 12 plus 12 times 1 plus 6 times 16, the RAM. So 0.5 times 180, that will be 90.0 gram. So the answer. Alright, try to do question E, F and G as a exercise. Alright, so next part we will move on to these few some objective question. We try to do some objective question. Alright, why carbon 12? We check why carbon 12 is chosen as a standard atom, because this carbon 12 is a most abundant abundant element. And this carbon atom also exists as solid. It's very easy to handle. So the answer will be carbon is solid and easier to be handled. Alright, we try to do this question. Potassium hexacyanoferrite. Okay, they want us to find the relative formula mass. So how to find here? Potassium K3FeCN, close the bracket 6. Okay, the potassium RAM all is given here. The RAM of this substance is given here. Alright, so we try to use potassium 3 times 39 plus iron 56 plus open bracket. Close the bracket, put 6 in front. The carbon is 12 plus nitrogen is 14. So the answer 329. So the answer will be D. We try to do question number 7. A compound with the formula X2CO3 with a relative formula mass is 138. So 2X plus carbon is 12 plus 3 times 16 oxygen. So the compound is given here. The compound, the relative formula compound is given, the RAM is given here. We try to apply, we try to find the RAM of X. Alright, so equivalent to the relative formula, the relative molecular mass is given. Relative formula mass is given, is equivalent to 138. Alright, it's 138. So 2X plus 60 is 138. 2X will be 2x 138 minus 60, so the x will be 39. So answer A. Alright. Okay, try to do this as an exercise. Because for this question number two. Okay, 8 atoms of X has the same mass of 2 atoms of tellurium. What is the relative atomic mass of X? Okay, so I put here 8 times RAM of X is equal, same mass, equal mass of 2. 2 atoms, that means RAM of TE. Alright, so we want to find the RAM of X, 2 times RAM of TE. Divide with 8, so that will be 2 times RAM of T is 128, divide 8, so the answer will be 32, the answer will be C. Alright, so what is mean by Avogadro constant? Avogadro constant means number of particles that present in one mole, so the answer will be D. Alright, so we try to do this question. So here they ask atom 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 atom. Which of the following contains 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 atoms? So it should be 1 mole. And we try to check the nature of the substance. Nitrogen N2, this is molecule. Chlorine Cl2, this also is a molecule. Non-metal. Ammonia NH3 also exists as molecule. So neon Ne exists as atom. So they want the atom. So answer D. Alright, so we check this question, try to do as a homework. Alright, so next question, we try to do the SPM 2018. Alright, so we try to do this one. Please check the question. The mass of an atom is very small. Therefore, the chemists determine the mass of an atom by comparing the mass of an atom with another atom called a relative atomic mass. The diagram below shows the mass of an carbon atom X when we compare with carbon 12, which is standard atom. And this carbon 12 atom, we need a 2 carbon 12 atoms. So first question, what is mean by meaning of relative atomic mass? The meaning of relative atomic mass is average mass of one atom of an element when we compare with 1 over 12 times mass of one carbon 12 atom. Okay, give a reason why the carbon 12 atom is used as a standard atom to compare the other element. This is because the carbon 12 atom easily available it, and it is a solid at room condition. Therefore, it's very easy to handle to determine the relative atomic mass of other element. Based on the diagram above, state the relative atomic mass of an atom, only of the atom X. So RAM of X equal as 2 times RAM of carbon 12 atom. Therefore, 2 times RA 12, the RAM of carbon 12 is 12. Therefore, the RAM of atom X is 24. Alright, so we go for next part, the number of moles and the relationship between the volume of gas. At the same time, the same temperature and atmospheric pressure, all the gases occupy the same volume, and the meaning of molar volume. Molar volume means the volume of the gas that fill in 1 mole of any gas occupy 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 particles of the gas. And we have a standard molar volume, the molar volume. We have two type of molar volume. One is known as STP and another one is known as RTP. STP stands for standard temperature and pressure, where the temperature is 0 degrees Celsius and the pressure is 1 atm. The volume of the gas is occupied 22.4 dm power 3. Room temperature and pressure, the temperature of the gases is 25 degrees Celsius, the pressure 1 atm, and the volume of the gases will be 24 dm power 3. And student must remember 1 dm power 3 equivalent to 1000 cm power 3, and 24,000, for example, 24,000 dm power 3 equivalent to 24 dm power 3 equivalent to 24,000 cm power 3. Alright, we try to calculate the number of moles for, if let's say the volume of gas is given, the number of mole, if volume of the gas given is volume divide with molar volume, volume divide with molar volume. From here, if student want to determine the volume of gas, okay, so we do what? Number of mole times with molar volume. The molar volume RTP equivalent as 24 dm power 3. STP is 22.4 dm power 3. Okay, let's try a few questions together. Alright, I'll check the first question. The number of moles of carbon dioxide is, only find the number of mole. They want us to find the number of mole, which is N, and given to student is volume of carbon dioxide, which is 500 cm cubic centimeter. Right, we try to check. So first step, I try to find number of moles, moles of, okay, carbon dioxide. The formula will be volume divide with molar volume. The volume is 500 cm power 3. The molar volume given in the question is 24 dm power 3, and student must remember this one is wrong. We must change the unit to dm to cm power 3, which we times with 1000. So the answer will be 0.021 unit will be mole. We try to do the second question. Find the volume of ammonia gas NH3. Okay, if the number of mole N, the number of mole given is 0.5 mole, they want us to find the volume. So from this formula, volume divide with molar volume, I try to find the volume. So volume of ammonia gas, okay, will be number of mole times with molar volume. The number of mole already given in the question, 0.5. RTP is 24 dm power 3. Therefore, the answer will be 12.0 dm power 3. Alright, we try to do a few questions here. Alright, question number 3. What is the volume of 34 gram of sulfur dioxide gas at STP? STP is given. A few information already given to the students, so we check the requirement of the question. They want us to find the volume, and given to student is mass. Mass, the sulfur dioxide formula will be SO2. The first step, I try to find the number of moles, moles of sulfur dioxide. How to find the number of mole when mass is given? Mass is given gram, number of mole will be N mass over molar mass. Alright, so the mass is 34 divide with sulfur 32 plus 3, 2 times 16, so the answer will be 0.53 mole. The second step we go for, we don't find the volume. The second step, we try to find the volume of sulfur dioxide gas. We want to find the volume of SO2 gas. The formula will be number of moles times with molar volume. The molar volume given here is 22.4, so the number of mole is 0.53 times with 22.4. the answer will be 11.87 d cubic decimeter. Right, so we try to do question number 4 together. What is the volume of 0.6 mole of methane gas? Volume of 0.696 mole of methane gas. We try to find the formula. Number of mole, volume, divide with molar volume. The number of mole, now we want to find the volume of methane gas CH4. So we rearrange the formula. That will be number of moles times with molar volume. The number of mole given in the question is 0.96. The molar volume is STP. STP 22.4. So the answer will be 21.50 dm³. Alright, we try to check question number 5. What is the volume of 3.7 mole of nitrogen gas? They want us to find the volume, so I straight away go for volume of nitrogen gas, number of mole times with STP. Alright, so the number of mole 3.7, STP 22.4, the answer will be 82.88 dm³. So the answer will be 82.88 dm³. Try to check question number 6 and 7. Try to do. Okay, as an exercise, we go for next relationship between the number of moles and the particles. As we know, the particles can be atom, can be molecules, and can be ions. Alright, so we try to check. 1 mole of any substance contains Avogadro constant, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 particles, same like in exactly the standard atom, which is carbon 12. Right, so we try to check the question number 2. The number of particles in 1 mole of substance is known as Avogadro constant, right, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. If the particles can be atom, molecule, or ion. Okay, the formula to calculate the number of mole. The formula to calculate the number of mole will be particles divide with Avogadro constant. So the particle can be atom. If atom, we use this formula. Atom divide with number of mole. Divide with Avogadro constant. If molecule, we try to use. Okay, molecule divide with Avogadro constant. If ion, we try to use number of mole, ion divide with Avogadro constant. We try to check few questions. Calculate the number of moles of 1.23 times 10 to the power of 23 sulfur dioxide. They want the molecules, how many molecules? So here I put here, so molecules. So the formula will be the molecules of sulfur dioxide divide with Avogadro constant. The molecules of sulfur dioxide, 1.23 times 10 to the power of 22 divide with 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. So the answer will be 0.02 mole. We try to check question number 2. Calculate the number of moles of 1.23 times 10 to the power of 21 carbon dioxide molecule. So the formula will be number of mole. We take the particles, which is carbon dioxide, divide with Avogadro constant. So the particle 1.29 times 10 to the power of 21 divide with 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. So the answer will be 0.002 mole. Right, okay, we try to check this question together. Okay, calculate the number of molecules present in water. Okay, molecules of water present in here given mass. If mass is given, try to convert the number of mass into number of mole. Number of moles of water, H2O. The formula, mass over molar mass. The mass given is 12 gram. The molar mass of water molecule, we try to find the RMM. Okay, so 2 times 1 plus 16, which is 18. So 12 divide with 18, that will be 0.67 mole. We go for second step. They want us to find the number of water molecules. So the water molecules, okay, the water molecules, number of moles times with Avogadro constant, 0.67 times with 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23, that will be 4.03 times 10 to the power of 23 molecules of water. Alright, try to check question number 4 as exercise. Okay, now we try to join Ani. I try to do the relationship between mass, number of moles, particles, number of particles, and the volume of gas. If let's say here, the number of moles will be the center. Okay, number of moles will be at the center. The unit will be mol. The symbol will be n. And if let's say the relationship between the mass and the number of mole, the arrow going up is divide. The one going down, multiply. So here we need molar mass, which is rmm, rfm, ram. And if let's say the relationship between the number of mole and volume of gas, we need molar volume. Okay, which is STP or RTP, and the relationship between the particles and number of mole is Avogadro constant. Right, we try to answer a few questions together. Okay, question number one. What is the volume of 12.8 gram of car oxygen gas? So here given to student is mass of oxygen gas. So the first step we convert into number of moles of oxygen gas. So we take the formula mass over molar mass. The mass given 12.8, the molar mass of oxygen 2 times 16, that will be 0.4 unit mole. The second step, they want the volume of gas. So volume of oxygen gas is number of moles times with molar volume. So I put here molar volume. The molar volume is 22.4, which is STP. Alright, so the number of moles 0.4 times with STP 22.4, the answer will be 8.96 dm power 3. Alright, we try to do question number 2. Okay, how many molecules in carbon dioxide are produced if the clue given to us is volume of carbon dioxide gas? And they want us to find the molecules. So first step, we try to convert this into number of moles. So I put here, okay, number of moles of CO2. So that will be n volume divided with molar volume. The volume given here is 500 divided with 24,000. Must remember, 24,000. Okay, so the unit answer will be 0.021 unit mole. Alright, so 0.021 unit mole. So the second step we go for, okay, number of molecules. So we try to do the molecules of CO2 will be n times with Avogadro constant. The number of moles 0.021 times with the Avogadro constant, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. The answer will be 1.26 times 10 to the power of 22 molecules of carbon dioxide. Alright, I'll try to do 3 as a exercise. We try to check question number 4 together. Calculate the mass. They want us to find the mass, and given information is 500 cm power 3 of carbon dioxide. So first step, we convert into number of moles of carbon dioxide. Take the unit, convert into number of moles. This is volume. So I take volume divide with molar volume to find the number of mole. The volume 500 divide with the molar volume 24,000, so the answer will be 0.021 unit mole. And the second step, they want us to find the mass. If mass, what is the formula to calculate number of mole? Mass over molar mass. Try to find how to rearrange this formula to find the mass. So I put here mass of CO2 will be number of moles times with molar mass. Okay, the number of mole given here 0.021, and the molar mass of carbon dioxide, carbon 12 plus 2 times 16 oxygen. So that will be 0.021 times with 44. The answer will be 0.93 unit will be gram. Alright, okay, I'll try to check question number 5 and 6 as a exercise. Try to do. We go for second part. Next part is empirical formula and molecular formula. So the empirical formula and molecular formula, how to determine the empirical formula and molecular formula? We start with definition. Alright, so how to do the definition? I'll take one compound, for example, glucose. The formula for glucose will be C6H12O6, and this glucose is made up of elements that are carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. And the number of atoms that present in this glucose molecule is 6 carbon, 12 oxygen, hydrogen 6 oxygen, and the ratio, or we call for simplest ratio. The simplest ratio of these compound is 6 divided by 6, which is 1, 12 divided by 6, which is 2, and the 6 divided by 6, which is 1. So the formula will be CH2. This is your empirical formula. Now we try to do the definition. The definition for empirical formula. Formula will be simplest ratio of atoms, whole number of atoms of each elements that present in a compound. Alright, simplest ratio of all number of atoms of each elements that present in a compound. We try to put here. Okay, so empirical formula will be simplest ratio of all number of atoms of each elements that present in a compound. Molecular formula will be actual number of atoms of each element that present in a molecule that form a compound. Alright, we try to find the empirical formula of few substance. Glucose is an empirical formula, divide with 6, divide with 6, divide with 6. So the formula CH2, I divide with integer 6. Alright, so this is divide with even number 2, 2. Alright, so CH3, so I divide with 2. This one we divide with 6, divide with 6. So this will be CH2, so divide with 6. Alright, this one, the benzene compound, we can divide with 6, 6, so CH, so divide with 6. Okay, ethanoic acid, we try to rearrange the formula, C total is 2, H total is 4, oxygen total is 2. So I divide with 2, divide with 2, divide with 2, therefore the formula will be CH2O, we divide with 2. Alright, if let's say one is even number, one is odd number, so we have two. This one cannot simplify, so divide with 1, divide with 1, so divide with 1, the formula remains the same, so which is C3H8. And we try to do this one, divide with 4, divide with 4, so CH, so I divide with 4. Alright, now we try to find the molecular formula. If we want to determine the molecular formula, which is the actual number of atoms of each elements that form a molecule that present in a compound. Okay, the formula to calculate the molecular formula, open bracket, write down the empirical formula given in the question, put N symbol or X symbol. When we sum up all the RAM inside the empirical formula, we should get RMM, which is relative molecular mass. Okay, so try to look at this question. We do together, the empirical formula is CH2. So what I do, I open bracket CH2, I write down the empirical formula, I put N symbol, the RMM value is given is 70, so 70. So now what I do, I try to add all the RAM already given, 12 plus 2 times 1, close the bracket, put N 70. Okay, so I do here 14 N is 70, N will be 5, okay, or N will be 70 divided by 14, which is 5. Okay, now I try to do the molecular formula, open bracket CH2, write down the empirical formula, apply the integer, N is 5. So we try to times here, the molecular formula will be C5H is 10. All right okay, we try to do question number 4 together. The empirical formula of ethane given is CH3, and the RMM value is given is 30. So we try to answer this question together, open bracket, write down the empirical formula, put the N symbol. When you sum up, you should get 30. So I put the 30 here. So 12 plus 3 times 1. Okay, then we put N is 30. Okay, so here 15 N is 30. N will be 2. 30 divided with 15, that will be 2. So we go for the, we write down the molecular formula here. The molecular formula will be, so I open bracket CH3, close the bracket, put 2, then I times here C2H will be 6. So this is the answer. Alright, I'll try to check this as an exercise, try to do. Okay, we go for how to determine the empirical formula. Okay, so we try to check out to determine the empirical formula. Try to look at the question here. 1.6 gram of iron is bonded with 0.72 gram of oxygen producing iron oxide. Calculate the empirical formula of iron. So how to do this question? So we try to do the table. We try to put the symbol of iron. So iron here, oxide, all oxide atom. The first thing we label, we try to find the mass. Okay, the mass is given 1.69 and the oxide is 0.72. Second step, we try to find number of moles. The unit I put here, mole, and the formula to calculate number of mole, mass divide with molar mass. The mass is given here, 1.69 divide with the molar mass is given here. Okay, we use the molar mass, which is 56, so the answer will be 0.03. all right, so now we checked for this one. 0.72, the molar mass of oxide or RAM of oxide is 16, so the I get answer 0.045 mole. So that means this is the this value we change, 0.030. Okay, 3 decimal point. Then we try to find the ratio. So ratio, we take the smallest number divide with the smaller one. Yeah, all the smallest number we check, this is the smallest number, 0.030 divide with 0.030, so I get 1. 0.045 divide with 0.030, I get 1.5. if 1.5, we have to round up this one into 2. When here we times 2, here also we have to times 2. Alright, so we have to equally round up both element. Alright, so that means we get here iron is 2, oxygen is 3, so oxide is 3. So this is the empirical formula. We try to check this question number 2. A hydrocarbon, what is mean by hydro? Hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon means any compound. Any compound that consisting of carbon and hydrogen atoms only. Alright, so that means here, if let's say the percentage is given, we take the percentage of carbon plus with the percentage of hydrogen, it should be 100%. Alright, so hydrocarbon always start with carbon and second hydrogen. So here I label hydrocarbon. Okay, this hydrocarbon contains 17.23. So 17.23% of hydrogen. That means we have to label here composition. Okay, composition by mass in 100 gram. All right, then we can convert the percentage into the gram. So carbon 100 minus 17.23, which will be 82.77 gram. The second step, we find number of moles. Okay, number of moles, the unit I put here, mole. So how to find? 82.77 mass divide with the molar mass is 12, which will be 6.898 mole. And here 17.23 divide with 1, so the answer will be 17.230. all right so we try to do the ratio. The ratio will be 6.898 divide with 6.898, so that will be 1. We take the smallest value, we compare these two value, we take this is the smallest, we divide. 17.230 divide with 6.898, that will be 2.5. when 2.5, we round up here 2 times 2, so the formula will be C2H will be here 5, so H will be 5. This is the empirical formula. Now we want to find the molecular formula, because the question, look at the question, they want us to find, determine empirical formula and determine the molecular formula. So if you want to find the molecular formula, use the step, open bracket, write down the empirical formula C2H5, close the bracket, and we try to find the RMM value, which is 58. We apply 58, so here 2 times 12 plus 5 times 1, close the bracket, put X and symbol. Okay, 58. So now we try to find the N. 29N is 58, N will be 2. All right, so we try to find the molecular formula C2H5, apply the N 2 here, so C will be 4, H will be 10. This is the molecular formula. All right, we try to check this question number 3 together. Alright, we try to do the this question. Okay, 42 gram of the mass is given, 42 gram of R is bonded with 16 gram of T. So this compound contains R and T. And this compound, the mass is given, mass gram, so 42.0, 16.0 gram. And the second step, we find the number of moles. So how to find the number of mole? Mass over molar mass, 42.0 molar mass, or RAM of R is not given. That means I represent with X symbol. Alright, 16.0 divide with the RAM of T is given 16. So I put here 16. And how to find the ratio? Ratio, we want to find the ratio. Just refer the formula given. What formula? The empirical formula. The formula is given here. R3, okay, T4. So take the 3, put here. 4 put here. And we now try to solve this question. 42.0x. Okay, then 16.0, 16 equal to 3 to 4. So 42.0x, 16.0, 16. So that will be 3 to 4. All right, so we try to check this question together. 42x times 16 divide 16, that will be 3 to 4. Okay, so we try to check this one, 42x. So this will be 1, 3 to 4. All right. Okay, so now I 42x, 3 to 4. Okay, so bring here this one, bring this one here. So 3x, 42 times 4. Alright, so that will be 3x will be 168, x will be 56. So the RAM, so here we can put RAM of x is 56. Alright, try to do this as exercise. Okay, we try to go for the last part of part 1, which is to determine the empirical formula of magnesium oxide. In this experiment, how to determine the empirical formula of magnesium oxide? So this is the drawing that I should draw. We take the crucible, we take the lead, the crucible with the lead. Okay, so we put the magnesium ribbon and we heat it up in the crucible. Alright, so we try to check what is mean by empirical formula. The empirical formula means simplest ratio of all number of atoms of each element that present in a compound. Okay, try to check the second question. Write down the chemical equation, the magnesium symbol Mg. The magnesium will be reacted with oxygen. So here I put magnesium react with oxygen. So symbol of heated, the product will be magnesium oxide. So magnesium Mg2 positive, oxide O2 negative, cancel, MgO. So balance the equation, oxygen 2. So I put 2 here, oxide 2. So magnesium, so here 2. So magnesium in front of here, we put 2. Okay, and try to check 2 mole of magnesium react with 1 mole of oxygen to produce 2 mole of magnesium oxide. And always remember, this is a white color powder. Alright, so observation at the end of the experiment, we will get a white color powder in the crucible. We try to explain few questions. Explain why the magnesium ribbon need to be cleaned with sandpaper. So this is to remove the layer of magnesium oxide on its surface. Because magnesium is a reactive metal, so it can react with the oxygen and can form the magnesium oxide layer. We need to remove the layer by rubbing with sandpaper. Okay, why the lid must open occasionally or every interval of time to allow the oxygen from the air or from the environment to enter the crucible for the complete combustion of magnesium, so that the oxygen can react with magnesium, form magnesium oxide. All right, so we go for next one. Okay, try to check this question. When the magnesium ribbon start to burn, okay, start to burn, the lid must cap close. Explain why. This is to prevent the white fume. The white fumes is magnesium oxide that react on here, the magnesium oxide that form. From what? From escaping. Escaping into environment. Okay, so we must remember the white fume are actually magnesium oxide. We try to check the white fume, so the white fume is here. Students can check here. So this white fume, this is the white fume that this is known as a white fume that produced when magnesium react with oxygen. So we will get the magnesium oxide to here. This magnesium oxide is a white fume. We don't want the white fume from escaping into the environment. Alright, so we try to go for next question. The state another metal that which can substitute magnesium, that will be zinc. So if zinc react with oxygen, it will produce zinc oxide. Balance put two year. And this zinc oxide, student must remember the zinc oxide, when hot, it will be yellow color and it will turn to white color when cold. Alright, so state two observation in this experiment. First observation, we try to go for three observation. The first observation, a white fume is released. The second observation will be a white color powder. White color powder form at the end of the experiment. At the end of the experiment. And the last one will be, okay, the mass of crucible and its content increases at the end of the reaction. At the end of the reaction, we can see the mass of the crucible and the content will increase. So this is the mass of the crucible, lead and magnesium. I try to draw again. This is the mass of crucible. This is the result that we get. This is before and during and after. So we can check the mass of the crucible and its content increases at the end of the reaction. So the first observation will be a white color fume is released. Second observation, a white color powder is formed at the end of the experiment. And third one will be the mass of crucible and its content increases at the end of the reaction. So we try to do the last question for this one and we try to go for calculation. Okay, the mass, how do you ensure all magnesium is reacted completely? We try to repeat these three process. Repeat HCW process. What is HCW process? I'll do here the process. The process of heating, cooling and weighing. Weighing is repeated to ensure that the magnesium reacts completely to form magnesium oxide. If we obtain a constant mass after this three process is repeated, that means all the magnesium reacts completely to form magnesium oxide. Okay, we go for calculation. Okay, I'll try to check the cuisine result given here. We try to do the table like this. Okay, we try to put all the information inside the table. First step, the magnesium oxide made up of magnesium and oxide. First reading that I needed is mass. So I put unit here. Second will be number of moles. the unit MOL, and the last step I try to go for ratio. Alright, so how to find the mass of magnesium? We cut the mass of crucible. Crucible, crucible cut. Lead, lead cut. So we have magnesium. So the mass of magnesium will be 26.4 minus with 24.0. That will be 2.4. Now we try to find the mass of oxygen or oxide atom. We try to cut the mass of crucible. Crucible, lead, lead, magnesium, magnesium. So we have left oxide. So I take a 28.0 minus with 26.4. So 28.0 minus with 26.4, that will be 1.6. All right. So now try to find the number of moles. So the formula will be mass over molar mass. So 2.4 divide with 24, the answer will be 0.1 mole. 1.6 divide with 16, the answer will be 0.1. So ratio 0.1 divide 0.1 1, 0.1 divide 0.1 1. So the empirical formula, the empirical formula will be MgO. All right, so I'll meet you guys in next slot, okay, on determining the empirical formula of copper 2 oxide and how to do the chemical formula, chemical equation, and how to describe the chemical equation qualitatively and quantitatively. Okay, so that's all from me. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye.